So if 8x equals a, then our function, the delta function, is 8x equal a. Now what does it will tell? When x goes to a instead of 0 nav, when x goes to a, then delta of x will go undefined, will blow. It will go too high here. And if I will consider this area under the curve, this area under the curve, again this will be equal to 1. And I will write this nav is integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and delta of x minus a dx, and this is equal to 1. Because now instead of x minus 0, I will write x minus a, and when I will associate this with a function, then it will be something like this. That let's say we are having a function f of x, and from minus infinity to plus infinity, this is f of x, and I do multiply the Dirac delta function with this one, delta x, and I do integrate it. Now I know that it is just like multiplication by 1 with a function, so it will not affect the actual value of our function. While it will give value only from minus infinity to plus infinity, it is giving value only at one point, which is x equal to 0, while for all other values this will be equal to 0. So it gave the value at the origin, it gave the value at 0, and our function, if it will be having a problem at x equal to 0, then by the association of the Dirac delta function with this one, we will get the value of that function at that point. Similarly, I can also write that integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, f of x delta of x minus a, then this thing is equal to, and it is integrated on dx, then it delta function will give value only when x will be equal to a. For x not equal to a, all other values will be equal to 0, and then this thing will be equal to f of a. And in the same sense, I can write for delta x minus a, delta x minus a, this thing is equal to 0 f x is not equal to a, and this is undefined f x is equal to a. So the very first thing in the Dirac delta function, first I will look whether this value, this domain, is under this range from minus infinity to plus infinity, and then I will be able to solve this situation. Now let's say I solve an example, and this example is example 1.14. Example 1.14, it says, evaluate the integral from 0 to 3 x cube delta x minus 2 dx. So let me write this integral, and this is from 0 to 3 x cube delta x minus 2 dx, and evaluate this integral. So look at the integral first. The very first thing in the Dirac delta function that I will confirm, and that will be to look at this value. And now this value is equal to 2, and I will see that whether it lies between these two points. Means like whether, this is for example 2, so whether we are giving a range of integration from 0 to 3, then our delta function will be lying in that range. If it will be lying outside of it, then the result will be equal to 0. So I see that 2 is between 0 and 3. So by just applying this thing, this is our f of x, x cube. This is delta x minus 2. 2 is equal to a. And this dx here, so this will be equal to f of a. What is f? It is equal to x cube. So it will be a cube here. And this thing is equal to 8 here. Now if for example we are given the expression like this, that 0 to 3 and x cube delta of x plus 2 dx, then first I will convert such an integral to the x minus form. And this will be equal, means with no harm, I can write it from 0 to 3 and then x cube delta x minus minus 2 and dx. Now the value of a is actually equal to minus 2. Now whether minus 2 is lying between 0 to 3, and the answer is no, it is not lying there. So our result will be equal to 0. Because this value is not lying in this range. Our delta function is not lying in this range, and then it will be equal to 0. If our integral limits will be like this, that from let's say minus 3 to plus 3 and x cube delta x plus 2 dx and evaluate this one, then I can write this from minus 3 to plus 3 and x cube delta of x minus minus 2 dx here. Now minus 2 is lying between minus 3 and plus 3, so it will be equal to minus 2 power 3, and this will be equal to minus 8. And this way we will be able to solve the Dirac delta function problems. Now I can write some other corollaries as well, which are in the form of example, and this is example 1.15. It's also the proof of one of the corollary of Dirac delta function, and this one says show the delta of kx equal 1 over k absolute delta of x, where k is any non-zero constant. In particular, delta of minus x is equal to delta of x. Like if we change the domain here, means from delta of x to delta of minus x, then it is an even function and it will not be disturbed by this. So I can now solve this example. Let me write the example. Delta of kx, where k is any constant, is equal to 1 over k absolute and delta of x. Prove this result. So let's say I just write the definition of the delta function, and now this is from minus infinity to plus infinity. If I don't write the limits, then it means that these limits are from minus infinity to plus infinity, and f of x and then delta of kx dx here. So we will evaluate this one. Let we suppose that kx is equal to y, then we will have x equals to 1 over k times y, and dx will be equal to 1 over k and dy here. So I can do this conversion, and this conversion will be minus infinity, means this will come out to be, this will come out to be minus infinity to plus infinity here, and then f of x. So for x I can write 1 over k means 1 over k over y. So this will be f of y over k, and here I can write delta of y, and then because kx is equal to this, and for dx I can write 1 over k and dy here. Now if I look at this one, what about the limits? Look here, if k will be like here, as we know that x is running from minus infinity to plus infinity, this is the limit of x. So if k will be positive, then y will also be running from minus infinity to plus infinity. But if k will be negative, then the integral will be running from plus infinity to minus infinity. And when we will reverse this one, then it will be from minus infinity to plus infinity, while the minus sign will come outside. So it means that this will be equal to plus minus integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and 1 over k will come outside, so it will be 1 over k, and this will be f of y over k, f of y over k, and delta of y and dy. So now this thing is equal to plus minus 1 over k, because 1 over k will come outside, and this if I do calculate, then this will means when y will be equal to 0, it will give us value, otherwise not. So for y I will put 0 here, 0 divided by k will come out to be 0, and this will be equal to f of 0. And this plus minus k I can include in this, k is k absolute. So when k will come out of the absolute, it will become plus minus 1 over k, and then f of 0 here. And I can see here that what if we will have this thing equal to f of x delta of x dx, then it will be equal to f of 0. So it means that this thing is right, that delta of kx is equal to 1 over k here absolute, and then delta of x. So this is one of the proof of the Dirac delta function.